There is a need of the marriage between the two disciplines. And there comes the concept of fusion. And fusion cannot take place in a day or two. It requires a lot of efforts, a lot of discussion, a lot of churning. And for that purpose, we need a forum. The Indian Science Communication Congress offers a forum to bring together the scientists, the journalists, the media persons, communicators, fiction writers, literatures, and anyone who can contribute for the cause of science communication. Maybe a scientist, or a journalist, or a media person, or a person who is working in a bank with a science qualification, or a person working with the railway, can also contribute to his or her might for science communication. So all are welcome for the common cause of bridging the gap between science and society. And I think this is the forum we have been continuing for last 9 years, and we hope to continue for the future as well, so that karma goes on to an expedition. And our idea is that every citizen of the country must have at least some common minimum knowledge of science. And that we call the minimum science, or we can term it science for all. So we are trying to define a certain level of minimum science that every Indian citizen must have. And through the mass media, be it print media, electronic media, digital media, folk media, or even interactive media, we are trying to penetrate deeper into the society, because media as a vehicle, media as a tool, is very important for taking the message of science to the common man. Okay, vision is clear, efforts are clear, we are motivated, we are ready. Then where is the problem? Why it is not taking place? What are the hurdles? Why everybody is not happy with the science coverage in media? Why everybody is still in this country is running towards superstitious practices? Most of the people suffering from various diseases which are easily curable, like more than 80% diseases are caused by unpotable drinking water, everybody knows. Lacks of children, lacks of common men, they are dying of petty diseases like jaundice, cholera, diarrhea. These are easily curable. Why it is not happening? What are the problems? When it comes to the science communication, only big things appear in our mind, like launch of satellite, or some breakthrough, or some nuclear something nanotechnology, or something like that. But countries like India require more emphasis on the small science that is confronting to our day-to-day life, like potable drinking water, energy problems, and so on. So we were discussing the problems. One of the important problems is that the recognition of the field I was just discussing with Dr. Professor Barua this afternoon. Those who are in science stream, if they try to put their efforts for science communication or science writing or science journalism, their job is not considered to be serious. If a scientist generally expected to write a research paper, present a well-researched work in the National International Conference, but when it comes to writing in the newspaper, when it comes to giving a program on television, when it comes to giving a talk on radio, they are not recognized in their fraternity, because that work is considered to be non-serious work. As a matter of fact, this is not the case in India. It's a world global phenomenon. It has not emerged today. Carl Sagan, a great physicist, when he started science writing or science popularization, science fiction writing, he was denied the Nobel. It is recorded. It is history. Similarly, I happened to meet a professor from France, Edouze, Professor Edouze, who won the International Kalinga Award for Science Communication by UNESCO and Kalinga Foundation of India. When I asked him, sir, when you joined this science communication business, he says, after retirement. Why, sir? Because now I don't want promotion. So that is the case with the scientists. Now, let us turn toward the journalists. I know many journalists in India and abroad. If they are in the main beat of journalism, main desk, they have all resources, all recognition, all power. But when it comes to science communication or science journalism, they are not recognized in their fraternity. Even I should not name a person with Hindustan Times, for the whole life he worked as science journalist and he was denied his promotions. At the last warning came, you are going to be removed if you will not change your beat. Then he says, sir, what is the offer? You go to foreign beat. He happily joined that. Not happily, unhappily, but he became happy. Every month he started going with Prime Minister, with some minister, some delegation. He was very happy. Every visit was able to reap him something like $1,000 or so. Happy. Then he had to sacrifice science journalism. So these are the problems, recognition. Then another problem is language. Language of communication. Generally, the scientists who are the custodians of the scientific knowledge, they tend to write research papers which is not comprehensible to the common man. To make it comprehensible, a lot of efforts are required. Communication skills are required. And most of the scientists, they are well versed with technical communication, but when it comes to public communication of science, they feel it difficult. They find it difficult. But at the same time, when it comes to the journalist, most of the journalists, they come from non-science background, humanities background. They also find it difficult to understand and assimilate the scientific jargon. So there comes a great gap between the scientist and the journalist. That gap has to be bridged. That is why we need a lot of science communicators and science enthusiasts all across the country. And the third problem is the local language. When it comes to communicating to the elite class, I think English is first. English is okay. But when it comes to communicating with the common man, people at the street, it becomes very difficult. So I think we need to use the local languages. Not only local language, but local dialects are required for science communication. And most of the scientists who are sitting at the ivory tower, they find it very difficult to speak in the people's language of the people at the street. So these are some of the problems, these are the issues which we require to discuss over here, to deliberate over here, and to try to bring some kind of structure for where science and communication can meet together, and the bridge between science and society can be created.